It's the 5th of June and the first morning in Pete's new house in West Sussex. After a year living in a rented pad in Brighton, he's invested in a dream property he hopes will be a happy family home for many years to come. Princess and Junior have their own rooms on the top floor, and Pete has converted a special room on the ground floor for Harvey. When Pete's not relaxing in his boudoir, he'll be showing off his culinary skills in his state-of-the-art kitchen. Down a leafy lane, a short drive to junior school, it's just perfect for the kids. And so the family can make the most of the new garden, Pete's having an adventure play area constructed.
It's going to be a big play area. You know where you can go on slides and go in the playhouse?
As Pete oversees the build, he's feeling positive about the move.
It's just going to be great, really. It's just going to be great. I just want them to be so happy. Look at Junior, look at him. Look, he's hanging out with the boys, he's learning how to do stuff. Jay is definitely an outdoor kid. He's an outdoor kid, like, through and through. Princess is an indoor kid. You know, she likes going outside, but she loves her little, you know... Look at him, look at him. Have a look. Look at him. He's just one of the boys.
If I hold the saw, then you can push it, yeah?
Listen, Junior, you be careful, though, son. I want all your fingers at the end of the day, thank you.
See?
Pete leaves Junior and Princess with their nanny and heads to his old house in Brighton to collect the last of his possessions. Pete moved here when he first split from his ex-wife and adjusted to life as a single man.
It's been amazing.
It's had a lot of emotions in this house.
Do you know what that means?
Ups and downs. I'd say more ups than downs, definitely. It's been a big transitional year.
But it's time to go, and that's the thing. It's when it's time to go, you've got to go.
I feel really sad because this was an amazing place for the kids, you know. I mean, look at this compared to the size of his new room, though. But it was just... the kids loved it, man. They loved it, they loved it. There was so much good feeling here, you know. And don't forget, I've got to get all my jewellery and stuff now. Where's my wedding ring is what I want to know. Idiot! How? Great. Let's get the cops around here. That'll be fun. Yeah. Oh, there it is. I have not seen that for well over a year now. My gosh, that we used to call it the fridge. That's huge. It was a great ring. My God, amazing ring. I haven't seen that for ages. Absolute ages. Oh, goodbye, house. Oh, man.
I was blind, not insane. You better leave her out of me. I was blind.
I've done it now. I've got my own house. For me, I've risen from the ashes. I feel good, I feel strong, I feel positive. And that old saying of if you put your mind to something, you can achieve anything, I believe that. I believe that you fight for something, you can get it. You work hard, you will get what you want. Oh, Junior's bike and Princess's tricycle, that's good. Oh, fantastic. Let's get in there.
Back at Chez André, it's time to have some fun in the garden.
Go, slide.
Boy.
Greatly appreciate it, man. You guys worked so hard on this. Thank you.
This is one of their birthday presents, one of the three
three kids' birthday presents right there. Go and enjoy yourselves, kids.
Locals are itching to meet the new kids on the block and welcome the Andre family into the neighbourhood.
So you're next door?
Yeah, me, yeah.
This one here?
This is my house.
And these are all your kids?
No, all my kids. No, I just brought them all up. I brought the whole street.
Well, look,
at the same
you
time.
Know, while Junior and Princess are here, I'm really happy for them to play with That's the kids if they want to. Yeah. It's like a real little community. Do you want to go with Princess? Come on, sweetie.
She's a. What's the word?
Shy.
Starstruck.
Makes me happy to see them play. At least I know now the kids can have fun, you know? It's just superb.
But just as he starts to settle in, Pete gets disappointing news about Harvey, who he's not seen for over 2 months. He's staying in Cambridge with his mother, and Pete was hoping to spend a few hours with him tomorrow.
I've just spoken to Kate's lawyers. Kate has apparently now made plans for tomorrow. This was for Harvey to come, right? And the only option she is offering is that she bring Harvey to you tomorrow morning and stay with him. She has also told her lawyers that she will liaise with you about this. So basically, I'm sending her one back saying, Kate, thank you for offering to bring Harvey to visit tomorrow. It's absolutely not necessary. The new nanny Eva, who you've approved, is happy to work, and I can arrange not only to pick her and Harvey up and to be collected and then brought here and then dropped back to you. I know you have now made plans for tomorrow, so let me know what time suits best ASAP. I want to see Harvey. I do not want to sit and talk with Kate. I've got nothing to talk with her about. I need to talk, spend time with Harvey. I'm not doing it.
I'm not spending time with her.
Coming up, Pete tries out some new positions.
I've never actually been in that position before with a man, and I find that very strange.
And there's confessions on the couch.
My parents thought I was recording, but I was actually in a psychiatric ward.
It's Sunday the 6th of June, just days after Pete moved into his new property in West Sussex.
What a BEA beautiful day.
The new home will provide long-term security for his family, something that seemed impossible a year ago.
The day I left my wife at the time, I rang Claire and I said, I know my career's over if I make this decision, but I've made it and I'm out. And I expected it all to go to plummet, because what I didn't expect is the support to be so strong, and then for me to find my feet so quick and sort my life out, you know? I remember when I was renting a house and there was one person that was sending a letter every week calling me a coward. Ha, 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 you're just renting a place, you've got nothing. You know, you're gonna end up in the gutter. And a year later, I'm thinking, well, I've got my own place now. I'm standing on my own 2 feet by myself, supporting my kids and feeling fantastic. So I guess that was the answer to that one.
The kids set about exploring the new house with their newfound friends.
Go and put your shoes on and then you can play outside. No running in and out of the house because we've got... Them? No. You're going to play with your friend now? Yeah. There's all your toys there, Princess, all right?
And just go, everyone.
What?
Just go.
You're kicking me out of your room now. Have fun with your friend. Go on. Cheeky little monkeys.
Princess and her playmate have taken over the unpacking of the toys.
Right, she went up with her friend to a room. She got all her toys out. She goes, right, now, can you all get out, please?
Who's the back?
Princess. Oh, look at you two. Oh, wow. You're so cute. I could not believe it.
With the weather taking a turn for the worse, Junior's unable to play outdoors, so he's keen to go round to his new best buddies next door.
I really want to go to my friend's house for about 6 hours.
And we'll see how it goes, OK? Princess wants to play with me, don't you? Have you done a poo or a pop?
A pop.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, right? I'm going to let you go and play for a little bit, but when you come back, you are going to bed because you have to get up early tomorrow. OK, we make a deal? Deal. Say deal.
Deal.
Right, let's do it. Are we friends or what? Are we best buddies? First time ever I've dropped my son off at the next door neighbour's. And he loved it.
I knew you should. I knew you could. I knew you would.
He leaves home for the London studios.
What's up, baby?
Woo!
Over the last 2 weeks, he's guest hosted the 5 o'clock show, and today is the last day of recording.
Basically, I'm here for my final day. I've had such a good time, you know, presenting this show, the 5 o'clock show, and I am a bit sad that it's all over.
First, it's time for a quick rehearsal as he gets to grips with an unusual new fitness craze which will feature on the programme.
Alright, let's give this a go. Step up here to me. Am I dumb enough to believe? When somebody says jump on this, would you follow them on your knees? Am I wrong? Alright, to be dancing with you tonight. Said I'm done with his fantasies. What I got is my sanity. My baby knows what I've never actually been in that position before with a man, and I find that very strange.
Ninety minutes later, and Pete gets set to present for the final time.
It's been such a great buzz and an opportunity for me to do this. Yeah, there's been 2 shows a day, and sometimes you think, oh, wow, you know, there's so much to remember, so much studying to do, but in all fairness, I just think it's been the best opportunity ever for me, and I think that this has helped me grow so much, and it means that I can step away from this, watch some of it back, and next time I get the opportunity, hopefully, I can be better. Please welcome Craig Phillips, Nadia Almada and Brian Bello. There is a rumour that some of the all-time best contestants of Big Brother are going into this house at some point. So can you tell us about that?
I think a few of us will make an appearance in there throughout the series. Some may be sooner than others, some may be towards the end.
I don't know anything about it. Like today, I left my house of
You don't know what day it is, Brian.
He was cuddling me like that. I'm like, where do you think I'm going? He goes, I won't see you for another 3 months. I'm like, I'm going to Peter Andre. I'm like,
that's what she meant.
I think all in all, it was a fantastic show. Brian Bello just made the show for me. It's just absolutely brilliant. We've had such an amazing time. I'm glad we've done it now, and I can rest, and there's another 2 shows we've already pre-recorded, so good stuff.
Good morning,
DJ Messiah.
Good morning.
Next morning, Pete's back at the TV studios. In response to the growing public interest in Pete's life, he's published a new picture book, and today he'll appear on This Morning to talk about it.
I'm doing an interview promoting my new book, which is called My World, in Pictures and Words, which is all about my world in pictures and words.
There's definitely some words in it.
And a lot of pictures.
And some pictures.
Yeah.
But are they yours?
They're my words and my pictures.
Well, did you take all the photos?
I didn't, so really...
It's in your words and some of your pictures.
And someone else's pictures.
Well, no, some of your pictures.
Mike.
Come on then, everyone.
Phil and Holly are primed to grill Pete about his life in the media spotlight.
It wasn't all plain sailing, was it? Because you, eventually, it led to you having really quite severe panic attacks.
Yeah, the panic attack started in 1998. I'd just finished the arena tours. I was on a massive high. The minute I stepped away, something hit me. It was like a ton of bricks. It was like all these pent-up emotions that I had never experienced before. I was fearless. I partied all the time. I didn't care. I was quite selfish. And then all of a sudden, something happened. I had this massive panic attack, and from then on, for 2 years, it was 20 a day. And they last for about half an hour, so that was really terrifying experience, but people should know that you can and you will get through
it. You were admitted to a psychiatric hospital, weren't you?
Yeah, I was, actually. I admitted myself into a psychiatric hospital because I didn't want to tell anyone what was going on, and my brother Mikey knew about it, my brother Chris, and they came and visited me in New York where my parents thought I was recording, but I was actually in a psychiatric ward. I had to sort myself out, and I did.
After bearing all to the nation, Pete's keen to get feedback from Nicola and Mike.
Yeah. How was it?
It was really good.
Yeah?
Really good interview, good. Peter.
Yeah, very good.
Spoke really well about everything.
And how
Loved
did it look?
Really good.
Okay. Are you happy with the hair, mate?
It looked good.
Coming up, Pete meets a blast from his past.
Oh, my God, I haven't seen this man for 10 years. Oh, yeah.
And a fan reduces him to tears.
Just give us 2 minutes, everybody, OK?
Pete's embarking on a whistle-stop signing tour, visiting 11 different venues from Edinburgh to Yeovil in just 7 days. And first up is London's Piccadilly, where Pete's also arranged to meet up with the music...
Right,
OK.
Molly Meldrum, who found me on the talent show. That's a blast from the past. Plast? That's a blast from the cast. How are yous?
You all right?
Good, yeah.
Hey! Oh, my God, I haven't seen this man for 10 years.
How are you? I'm good.
Oh, wow. this is the man, just so you all know, this is the man that signed me up live on TV. Well, I've talked about it all these years, 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. He was the one that saw the vision when everyone else was like, what the hell are you doing? A lot of people kicked his ass afterwards, but, you know, I was thinking why.
And then I kicked his ass for a few times after that. Going, what are you doing to me, you know?
How are you going,
I'm
mate?
I'm good. I'm really good.
Wow, yeah. 10 years. Yeah. We should never, ever lose touch now.
I know.
Pete's itching to get amongst his fans as he takes a genuine interest in the people who make the effort to come and see him.
Stop doing what you do because I think you're brilliant and I'm so proud to be your fan. You're a musical genius.
Oh, I love
absolutely
you.
Love you
so much.
We love who you are, Andre. We're going to marry him and yeah, I'll take weekends and you can have the week.
Yeah. Lovely turnout. Great what Waterstones have done here. Great display, good press call, lots of people. Everyone's up for it. Really nice. And it just gives you all that positivity for the regional signings because you know they're going to be even bigger. I think for Pete, you know, he had all that adulation while he was doing his tour. Getting back out with the fans and his fans are so good, so supportive. You can't help but be in a good mood. And it just kind of gives you a really good, nice vibe.
See you later. Thank you so much.
I love you too.
I love you too.
Pete's Bristol bound, where massive crowds have gathered.
Love kick starts again.
So, second signing of day one. We're in Bristol and we're pushing easily in excess of 1,000 people. So, I mean, how cool.
We want Pete.
They don't want me.
Pete.
See, they've got no interest in me. See?
Love kick starts again. Starts again.
Ceases to amaze you, different people's reactions. Some people come up and all they do is shriek, and then some people come up and they cry.
I can never remember signing this many copies of my autobiography, no way. The autobiography I did four years ago, I think it was,
The most we ever got at a signing was 300 people. The most. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Oh my God! Absolutely fantastic. What a lovely, lovely person. That's all I can say. True to nature. Oh!
Bye.
It is the best form of therapy as a British public.
You go and hear that sort of crowd reaction and you just go, oh my God, like triple adrenaline rush.
And it's goodbye Bristol and hello Yeovil.
You know what Nicola just said to me? I just said, Michael, it would be really nice if you read your brother's book one day.
Yeah, I will one day.
Right? Nicola turned around and goes, I'm not being funny, but it's the kind of book I would read in the toilet.
I meant it in a nice way.
And
lots
I meant
of people
it,
have a book in the toilet.
We've got
that
a
they
lot
read.
Of high quality paper, gloss paper there.
I know, but gloss, that would be no good.
No, reusable.
Hundreds of fans have lined the streets since 4 a.m. this morning and books are already selling out fast.
I heard it's mad.
Superb.
Can't wait.
Absolutely superb.
Can't
out
wait. It's good to be back.
We're back.
There's a lad in the queue, Lewis, who has the same condition as Harvey.
Oh,
okay.
Hello.
Hello, Peter.
Hello, Lewis. Let me give Lewis a cuddle.
Oh, that's really kind.
Good boy.
Give me a kiss.
All right, yeah. I want one too.
Ma.
Good boy.
Oh, lovely, Lewis.
Good boy.
Thank you very much.
Look at him, he gets like Harvey. Bye, Lewis.
Bye.
And we kind of. Not tight for time, but you need to keep things flowing. The moment that you're not flowing on a signing, it just slows everything down, and obviously it all takes so much longer. So you kind of say to Pete, right, Pete, you know, this is what we'll do. We'll just sign it. You know, try not to kiss people, and you know, just keep it flowing. But Pete, being Pete, it's like saying to him, don't talk, because you know he's going to. So you know, he chats away to everybody, he kisses everybody. He's got a hug, he's got a high five, he's got a handshake. But do you know what? That's what makes Pete Pete. And if he didn't do it, people wouldn't be asked to come out and see him. They wouldn't make the effort to come out and see him because they know when they meet him, although they're only going to meet him for a short time, it's what they're going to get out of that that's important.
Just a great overall bloke, isn't he, Clarky?
Yeah, top bloke, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
An hour into the signing, Nicola is alerted about a panic attacker in the queue. 32-year-old Tracy's agoraphobia is so debilitating that she's rarely able to leave the house. But today, she's braved the outside world to see her idol, Pete.
Thanks, mate. Just give me one second. What's wrong? What happened?
He's got agoraphobia.
Listen, I get them all the time, right? And they go. I promise you, they go.
Since I was 50.
Listen, let me just explain something to you. I had them 20 a day for 2 years, and they lasted for 25 minutes. So how many hours is that a day of panic attacks?
Yeah, I used to spend all my time.
I used to think that there's no way out. Like, this was a big thing for you today. But what you do is you find baby steps, just small little things, one at a time, and eventually, you'll just extend it.
Yeah.
I know, because I've done it. So you guys just stay strong. Oh, I know you've been through it, but you're going to get through
thank
it.
You so thank you.
And you've got to help each other. There is nothing impossible. Well, I know exactly what somebody like that goes through, and for me, it's really important to explain to them that nothing in your body can harm you. And if you know that, if you know that nothing in your body can harm you, then there's no way. Once you know that, you start beating it straight away. That's the only way I could beat it. 700 books signed, done. The whole store, that was every book that they've had. Fantastic. I'm going to go and wave to the crowd and say goodbye, and then we're going. See you later. Thank you.
the 15th of June and Pete's up north in Gateshead. He's just heard his book stormed into the midweek charts at number 2, so he's phoning manager Claire to tell her the good news.
Sometimes when you go to the toilet, you can just go and do a wee, or you can do a... Exactly. That's our midweek.
Big two.
Number two.
Oh, a number two. Really?
Number two. Can you believe it? I did not expect that.
Brilliant.
In a million. Did you just say a big
poo?
Poo.
That's what she was saying.
Well, that is brilliant. You see, what I was telling you the other day, when you were getting worried about things, you see, you need to have more faith.
Well, I did not expect that in a million years, so I am so grateful, and I think if that's...
I'm really happy for you.
Oh, I'm happy for us. That is huge. Speak to you Sunday. Big kiss. Bye. Bye. Oh, that is awesome news. So happy. So happy.
And now Pete's keen to mingle with the masses.
He keeps getting less and less clothes on every time I sign him. I know, he has washed them though.
Among the many faces in the crowd is 15-year-old Ryan, who's been a Pete devotee for over 6 years.
A very, very, very big fan. Annie Ryan.
Yeah.
He loves him.
For Ryan, the excitement of seeing his hero in the flesh is simply overwhelming.
You're my buddy. God bless you.
Thank you.
Come here,
I'm
actually
a wonderful man.
Come on then.
Yeah, have a tissue for a sec, because that really got me.
Boys, don't
touched by Ryan's emotional reaction, Pete struggles to fight back the tears.
Thank you. Oh, Jesus Christ, I don't need to do that right now, right?
You just give us 2 minutes, everybody, OK? Just, thank you.
It's OK, just have a minute. Just have a moment. We're nearly there anyway, so it's OK.
He's a very sensitive guy, Pete, and he feels... He feels for people that, you know, that aren't as fortunate as himself. Really does.
I can't believe he did that to me. Like, just didn't expect to react like that at all.
For him to wait in line for all those hours just to see Pete, and then, to, you know, waiting and then be happy about it all, and then have a smile on his face, but the second he sees him burst out into tears, it just got Pete. It just absolutely killed him.
It meant so much to him, and that... Listen, man, I'm strong, I just...
You meet these people that just make you appreciate everything that you have, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
You know?
And all the time I'm going to myself, dude, be a man, but I can't.
But you...
I can't.
But it's not being a man,
no.
Like not showing your emotions.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. Come on, there's only like three
there's
people
There's only
left.
A handful of Thank people left. We've done loads, it's all good, we've had a good day. Come on.
Yeah. Come on. How are you, buddy?
Pete somehow finds the strength to sign the last few remaining books. It's been an emotional end to the nationwide signings tour in which Pete made dreams come true for over 6,000 of his fans.
That was just incredible. I mean, everything about that signing, it was madness. Just when you think things have died down, you get news like that, and then a crowd like that, and that guy,
a guy in the wheelchair. He just killed me.
Coming up, Pete's voted the daddy of all daddies.
I have been given this to say that I'm the best daddy.
And it's the birthday bash of the year. It's the 17th of June, and Pete's in central London to collect a special accolade for Father's Day.
So here I am, bright and early in London, because I got the news last night that I've been voted Celebrity Dad of the Year. I had no idea, absolutely no idea. This is the biggest honour. I always said that no matter what award you ever win in your life, being voted as a good dad is always the greatest award.
And with 35,000 online votes, Pete beat celebrity dads Jeff Brazier and Gary Barlow to the top spot.
Very proud dad today, eh? I can't thank anyone else but me kids. Because if I didn't have them, I wouldn't get this award, would I?
About being a dad.
I think what happens is as soon as you do have kids, you become selfless. Your selfishness dies. You start putting all the attention on the children.
As always during press interviews, manager Nicola is keeping a watchful eye on proceedings.
And you were linked recently with Kerry Katona.
Guys, I'm not going to go down a route. Sorry.
Well, it wasn't talking, true anyway, so it doesn't matter.
About right. Clients okay. Of ours.
Sorry. I was going to ask, when you're trying to have a new relationship,
guys,
how do you balance that
I'm
with
so
children?
I'm so sorry.
No?
I'm not going to go down a route at all. Thank you very much.
I think it's because of the kids thing.
And you recently had the tattoo removed. How's that
no,
feeling?
No, I'm really sorry, guys, again. I'm not going that
Ladies
route
and gentlemen,
either.
Nicola Partridge.
I brief everybody that I speak to and I say we can't talk about this, we can't talk about that, but I appreciate they're journalists and they're not doing their job if they don't try to get in a couple of cheeky questions, but I think we handled that okay, but good day.
Pete makes his way home to Sussex to share his achievement with his mum and sister, who've flown over from Cyprus.
It's empty Hello. In the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly.
Hey. I help something
What's got
for
about?
You. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you, Mom.
Look. Oh, lovely.
Look, Junior and Princess Daddy, one father
look at
the year. Give me a kiss.
Daddy.
This is my nephew, Savandi. My sister, Debs.
Congratulations.
And this is my beautiful mum's sister.
I will hold on hope and I won't let you choose.
Who's your daddy? Who's the daddy? Can I tell you what this is, Princess? I have been told, given this, to say that I'm the best daddy.
Daddy.
Am I the best daddy? Who's the daddy? It's so good to have my mum here and my
I love
sis.
You.
I love you too and we're going to go.
I love you, my son.
She's proud of me because I won Daddy of the Year. But her husband was the best daddy of our lives. He was, well, he was the only daddy of our lives. Hello. But I mean, he was the best daddy. Go. Whoa. Go on then.
Next morning, it's Father's Day and Pete is celebrating. Today, he'll host a big birthday bash for Junior, Princess and Harvey. And it's also an opportunity for Pete to show off his new pad, so he wants it to look the biz.
Just mad trying to get it all ready. Right, it is a joint birthday party today for Junior Princess and Harvey. For reasons I won't go into, Harvey will not be here today. But all his presents are there, they're all waiting for him, so whenever he comes over, his bedroom's ready, and it's all his presents are in there. So we'll wait for him to, when it's all sorted out and everything's fine, and then he can come and enjoy his day. He's got quite a few, you know. He's got like all sorts of things, and this big, massive plaything that we're gonna build him. You know, it's here for him when he comes. Everything's ready for him, so. And I've got this massive plaything down the bottom that we're gonna build when he gets here, because it'll be more fun, and so, a few little more things to wrap. Junior's may not look like a lot. He's already opened about 5, because honestly, I could not keep him. Every day he's asking, please, please, please. So I've let him open like a present an hour today. But Junior's big present, ladies and gentlemen, is a D-Type Jag 1950 classic, custom made. It's taken nearly a year to make. And it's sitting under there. 1950s Jaguar. It's got his number plate on it. It's got 5 on either side. There's different speeds, variable speeds. I'm gonna set in on a speed for him. I've got a key with me, so if he's next to me and I'm riding my bike and I see he's starting to go like that, I press a button and it cuts it all off. Now, Mum, the cakes are here. Where am I going to put them?
Leave them in the garage. It's cold.
In the garage.
Oh, my God.
Brilliant. Well, there was a cake.
Whoa. No, it didn't move. It didn't move. Pack it up, pack it out. Let me begin.
That's a sin. I won't tell my slack up.
I hope
you're
not. I'm sorry. That is amazing.
Right, let's bring this one over here.
See where this is going to have to go to Harvey's home.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
It has to, man. I mean, that's going to go to waste. Oh, my God. Wow. I can't make it down. I can't make it down. You're from junior school, right? Jump around. Jump around. Hey, Nick.
Really good, babe. Really, really good.
Neville's here.
I don't believe it.
How are you?
Good, man.
Good.
Hold on. The princess, your presents. Come and open some presents. Yay! Turn it around, turn it around. Look at that. What do you say?
Beautiful girls all over the world. I could be chasing, but my time would be wasted. They got nothing on you, baby. Nothing on you, baby. They might say.
Listen, I've got Genius' big present, and I want to get everyone out the front in about 15, 20 minutes for this present. Do you know what it is? Have you seen it?
I know you feel where I'm coming from, regardless of the things in my past that I've done.
I feel like I was the boy. How cool is this? And so I lost more than I had ever won. And honestly, I ended up with none.
So much nonsense is on my conscience. Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Junior. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Told you that'd be
present,
did I?
Oh,
do you like
it? Happy birthday to you.
Right. Come and watch Dad. Come and watch Dad, and then you can have a go, right? Ready? Wow!
Wait, ready? Just watch. All right, I'm coming back. Come on then.
Idiot.
Okay, now look, let me tell you what you're gonna do, Jay. Get inside your car. This is your, it's a D-type 1950s Jaguar that's taken a year to make. I ordered it on his last birthday.
Coming.
Go, drive your car. Woo! Yay!
Jump in my car.
When I was growing up, I was lucky to get one of those in a matchbox. And I was lucky to get one of those. That's all I wanted. And I even didn't get that. So, you know, to get a present like that, I mean, I'd be happy with that at my age.
Junior, not too much lineage in it. Leave her alone. She's, you've only just met.
Jump in my car. I wanna take you home.
My little boy, man. You know what? He's been going on about his presents all the time, and I said, just be patient. You know what? To his credit, he's been really, really patient. I've given him little bits and pieces, and I waited today for him to open most of his presents, but he had no idea there was one more.
Jump in my car.
Hopefully, this will be the first of many family parties here, an occasion that last summer Pete would never have dreamed possible.
He was in Claire's house and he was just a shell of himself, really, wasn't he? And then obviously he got the place in Brighton and moved in there, and obviously having that time and that space and Mike, I think, was a huge thing for him as well. And he gets himself back together slowly but surely. And now to be in this position just over the year later, purchasing this house, having really good people around him, nice people around him, the neighbours all coming in, and everyone's just got stuck in all together, had a really nice afternoon, and it's just been fun.
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
All right, blow your candles out. Yay! Yay! You hold my hand first, ready? Hold my hand. Go, and cut. Yay! Been an absolutely brilliant day, absolutely amazing. The kids have had the best time, and all this love, being, you know, crowned Father of the Year is amazing, but you know what, for a Father's Day gift, having the kids here, of course, there was one person missing, we know that, but it, you know, at the end of the day, everything's ready for him when he comes, and I just hope that that's gonna be sorted very soon.
Coming up next week, it's holiday time.
This is how we roll.
Pete gets friendly with the locals.
Ah, this is awesome.
And he faces his deepest fears.
Mate, honestly, I can't do this. Take me off, please. Please take me off.
Ah, lovely, gorgeous Peter. And I hate to be the bearer, but next week is the last one in this series of Next Chapter. I know, don't be sad, because it'll be the iTunes Festival here in just a sec. So it's not all bad now, is it?